Okay, we continue our Tisha B'Av marathon today because it's very important. Now let's continue off with another startling recognition. Boom. There is always only peace. There's already peace everywhere. There is absolutely no need to bring peace anywhere. This is the delusion. All is already at perfect peace. There's no lack of peace at all. None. What we're trying to do is trying to establish a lack of peace, and then we claim we'll fix that. Okay? We're trying to establish a problem with reality and then fix it. So if you look at all of history, all of the wars, the conflict, everything, suffering has only been an attempt on our part to establish a lack of peace. And this has been completely futile. Completely futile. There is no lack of peace. Everything is at peace, always. All is at peace, always. All is at peace, always. This is not something that we need to establish. So, with this 5th of August, we realize that there's all this, going to be all this turmoil in the world coming up. At least, that's how we look at it. But all of this is just, again, the attempt to establish a lack of peace. It's like trying to make an illusion real. We cannot establish a lack of peace because God's creation is peace. We cannot change what God created. So we cannot bring about any lack of peace. It's impossible. Everyone, all this action are just actors. Everyone is participating in this collective attempt. All these appearances. For example, one who knew the truth about the situation, Sri Ananda Maima, they asked her about World War II and all this conflict and all this hate. She says, what are you talking about? All is perfect peace. I don't see any lack of peace anywhere. What I see is two friends engaged in a little play that they're enjoying, and one knocks the other down, and then you know, the other knocks them down. And in other words, all this dying, etc. She saw it as it was just a game. It's just a game that's being played by friends who are willingly putting on this little play. Nisargadatta Maharaj also said, hey, what about this world? He says, hey, if a couple of boys put on a little play in the streets here in Bombay, you know, what do you have to pay attention to and label it and all that stuff? It just putting on a little play. So what? There is no lack of peace at all. So praying for peace is totally delusional, because that is basically saying there's a lack of peace. That's what it's really saying. There's a lack of peace, and I'm going to fix this. There is no lack of peace. So the realizers are simply here. They're not experiencing any lack of peace at all in the world. All is perfect. All is perfect. Always. They're not here to bring peace. They're here to tell us there's no such thing as a lack of peace. Okay, there's a big difference. All important difference. There's never been a lack of peace, ever. How can we say that? Because peace is the creation, and the creation is one. The creation, the pure spaciousness of creation where all is everywhere equally. Everything is already totally peacefully abiding in the oneness of pure spaciousness of God. Always. It is impossible that it could be any other way. So, it's impossible that there be a lack of peace. Totally impossible. So we're putting on a little play here and trying to drum up support for, hey, you know, just believe that there's a lack of peace. Just believe there's a lack of peace. So that, and then we'll say, okay, as soon as we can get that established, then we'll fix it. We'll be the peacemakers. There are no peacemakers. There are no peacemakers because there's no lack of peace. The great sages are not peacemakers. They're realizers. We don't need to make peace. We need to realize there is no lack of peace. See, this is the difference where the rubber hits the road between dualism and non-dualism, between delusional delusion and realization of reality. It's a huge difference, isn't it? The dualists insist that there's a lack of peace, but they're working hard to fix that. And the non-dualists know there is no lack of peace. It's impossible. There's nothing to fix. Now you might say, well, how does that help at all? Well, all these boys are putting on the play. When the world just simply realizes there is no lack of peace, therefore they're completely not the slightest bit interested in any attempt to pretend there is some lack. This is what sinks in. This is what sinks in. And then they may say, well, you know, why go to all this bother then, really? Why identify with form? And in the first place, it's ridiculous. So, lack of interest in, you know, will just drop away. It doesn't bring peace. It simply, there's a lack of interest in trying to establish a lack of peace. We all lose interest in it. So that's how the great gurus help us, okay? Is there's just a lack of interest in trying to establish a lack of peace. Because there's a realization deep down, it's impossible. So if you know it's impossible, you're going to stop trying. What's the point? Become disinterested in it. So you cannot bring peace to the planet. It's you just have to realize that there's no way to not, for the planet, for everywhere to not be peaceful. It's all peaceful. It's only peace. So why keep going with this foolishness of magic, like we're working on bringing a lack of peace? It's just, you know, it's silly. We can do it. It's fine, but it's silly. So now, as we go forward in this world, there are certainly going to be some extreme attempts to establish a lack of peace, okay? So extreme attempts. Remember, and it's all play with friends here. There's no victim and no victimizer. It's actually a play. It takes two to tango, to have an experience. Most that spirits find themselves in this situation, as it were, are frantically trying to establish that there's a lack of peace, so that they can be the peacemakers, so they can be greater than God. Say, God, there's some lack of peace in your kingdom, but don't worry, we're going to bring peace. We're bringing the peace. We got the truces, the alliances, the peace pacts, and all of this. As they say, when they're saying peace, 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 let those in Judea flee to the mountains, you know. Now I know the Psalms, various things, blessed are the peacemakers, and blah, 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 blah. That's dualistic, actually. should be blessed are the ones who realize and accept there's only peace, and there's no possibility that there could ever be a lack of peace anywhere, in any circumstance. So we need to at least get this, entertain this consideration. It's actually a fact. Entertain this fact as a fact prior to all of the attempts to establish a lack of peace really get flying, before the fists start flying. It's interesting. I was warned again about a huge flood in the desert, dam failing in the desert. And, you know, and now we have this, you know, capitulate to our demands, whatever that is, or we're going to flood you, we're going to blow up the dam, sort of thing. So this is an attempt to establish a lack of peace, okay? This is delusion. This is an attempt to drive us deep, deep, deep into delusion. Well, we don't want to go there because it's nowhere. It's like you're just going nowhere, but thinking that you are going somewhere, and interpreting that you're not going anywhere as an attack on your going somewhere, you see. So attempt to establish there's a lack of peace, you then believe that the peace that's already there is an attempt to attack your desire for peace, because you think your desire for peace is desire to fix a lack of peace. So the peace, the total peace that's already there, you think it's attacking you. You think it's against you. You think God is against you when you want to establish peace, but you want to be a peacemaker. You feel that God is actually your enemy because there is no lack of peace at all. In all of creation, there is no lack of peace. So dualism feels that God is against them, you know, is an enemy. There's no other way to look at it, actually. Like God's trying to deprive us of our true standing, which is to bring peace, to be the peacemakers. We feel that's our true calling, our true standing. No, because that's trying to establish ourselves as greater than God. Because in order to be the peacemakers, we would first have to bring a lack of peace in the kingdom and the creation of God, which is impossible. You see, we'd have to change reality, and that of course would make us our will greater than God. So it's very sneaky. We're saying, no God, we're just trying to be the peacemakers. No, we're trying to bring a lack of peace to the kingdom, try to change reality so that then we can say, look, we can fix it, God. We're greater than you. You had a problem, but we fixed it. So if we get this in the right context going forward, is very important. Right context is there is no lack of peace anywhere. There is no way to establish lack of peace. Even an atomic explosion does not establish lack of peace in the slightest bit. Pure spaciousness is not disturbed in the slightest bit. I know there's a lot of talk about extraterrestrials, how they say that the atomic explosions disturb the fabric of time, space, and dimensionality, and disturb their dimensions, and so we get the idea, oh my God, you know, atomic explosions establish a lack of peace. They do not in the slightest bit. The entire universe could disintegrate in an instant, and it would not establish a lack of peace in the slightest bit. Because where is the universe? Everything is always in pure spaciousness. It's always in a completely peaceful repose in pure spaciousness, and that can never change. So these are non-dual considerations. We're giving here non-dual considerations, which is what I've been listening to my whole life, listening to, and it hasn't been easy at all. It's not easy. It's like, whoa, wait a minute. That's very different. But it's super useful, it's super helpful and useful just to hear this, to hear it, and to hear it, and to hear it, and hear it. and consider it and ponder on it, not intellectually. Let it impact your vibe, your overall vibe, like what your whole being. Let it be absorbed by your being, like, wow, it's impossible to establish any lack of peace. There is no lack of peace, ever. Never has been. Well, what the heck have we been doing then, all these efforts of wars and history? Wasted time. Time idly spent. Meaningless. Idly spent. And he's like, wow, you mean I had all these births and I did all this, I suffered and died all this time for nothing? Right, for nothing, that's right. All to no avail whatsoever. As a, you know, seems like a bitter pill to swallow, but we have to swallow it. It's not that bitter. It's more like a wow pill. It's like, the ones that know this, they don't seem to be interested in conflicts or whatever's going on in the world. Nothing's happening. There's no lack of peace being established anywhere. So they're not concerned. They're not, their attention is, wow, I really got to, let's hold a prayer meeting for this, you know, Middle East conflict. We really got to stop them from fighting and all this stuff. They appear to be oblivious to anything in particular here. There's pure happiness. And if you say, hey, you know, can you help stop this conflict? They say, well, what conflict? There's no conflict. There's no conflict with God. Nothing's in conflict with God. There's no lack of peace anywhere. Everything's perfect. What do you mean to stop something? There's nothing that needs to be stopped. And again, foolishness is relinquished. When there's disinterest and we say, oh, we can't bring a lack of peace anywhere. Why should we keep trying? That's stupid. That's not what I really want to do. So that's how it comes. It comes because of realization. It doesn't come because we impose some peace upon something or get them to stop or laws or treaties or that has nothing to do with it. It's total disinterest, high indifference, absolute high indifference, which they said, you know, Sri Sri Anandamaya Maha, they said, you're so completely indifferent, it's like, seem to be just like vastly remote as far as engaging with what's happening here. There's this total seemingly remoteness, but it's not really remoteness at all. It's just the realization all is perfect. But of course, we think here in the world all is far from perfect. So we think, well, she must be, her consciousness must be somewhere very remote from this planet, right? Very remote from this planet. You see, this is the thing. It's because we think there's such a lack of peace here on this planet. Okay, when the true guru comes, the true savior comes, they know there's no lack of peace anywhere. Everything's perfect. And so you're saying, well, obviously there's a lack of peace here, and yet they're acting like there's no lack of peace at all. So their consciousness can't be here. We say it can't possibly be here. In fact, it can't even be near here. It must be very far away, because we think, wow, even from a distance we can feel the conflict of this planet. So it seems like they're remote from here. They're not remote. And we don't want them to come here. We say, I don't want your peace to be disturbed. I don't want your peacefulness to be disturbed. You better not come here. No, I need you in somewhere remote from here that I can maybe, we can have some communication. Just stay away from this planet. I don't want your peace to be disturbed, because your peacefulness is very important to me. But if you come here, for sure, it's going to be very badly disturbed. So maybe if you can just give us some channeling or something from, you know, from a remote area of the galaxy where everything's peaceful. But don't come here. So they don't show up here because we wouldn't understand. No, they're right here, right now. Everything's perfect here. Everything's perfect everywhere. There's no lack of peace anywhere. Never has been, never will be. What's the worries? There's no worries. They asked her, didn't this world make you unhappy and inconvenienced? She said, no, the slightest bit. What are you talking about? Everything's perfect. It's wonderful. I love it here. She said, I love it. It's wonderful. It's fantastic. It's so beautiful, so wonderful. Just like the whole universe. It's all peaceful. No lack anywhere. And we're saying, wow. Where'd you come from where it's that way? It really isn't that way here. She says, no, it's just that way here. So this is, we're just looking at this thing. Wow. We're raised here. You got to be peacemakers. You got to help the world. It's impossible that there be a lack of. It's impossible. There's no lack of. No lack of. Everyone's 100% in reality. We're trying to establish a lack of, but this is called karma. It's just we're not really bound by it at all. So see, the karma is not really true. We're not bound by anything. How can we be bound? That keeps us from pure spaciousness? Something keeps us from pure spaciousness? No, it's not. We're already there. Never left. So we, what bondage? There's no bondage. We can't be bound. But there's this play that we're playing of trying to establish lack, trying to establish it. It's all going absolutely nowhere. So, we can stop the video here, and this has introduced an incredible consideration, introduced an incredible, amazing, it's very credible, a very credible consideration, a very astonishingly credible consideration that, again, what's really going on here? We're trying to establish a lack of peace, all the while insisting, no, we want peace, we want peace, we want to establish peace. We're praying for peace. Let there be peace in the world. Please let there be peace. Totally dualistic. There's already only peace everywhere. But we think of this world as a special place where a lack of peace is apparent. So we like to come here, like, really, wow, there's some place in reality, there's a lack of peace. Oh, I want to see this. This is very interesting to me. And spirit gets pulled into this, see. But no, there's no lack of peace on this planet or anywhere. Everything is 100% perfectly, effortlessly abiding in the pure peace of all that is. No change has ever happened in any way, never will. And so this is a wonderful consideration. You don't pray for peace. You confirm that there's only peace. Just confirm that. So we don't need to pray. We need to confirm and declare. Confirm and affirm. We just need to confirm and affirm. This is the actual fact, and just say, hey, you're not establishing any lack of peace at all. Your wars and bombs and stuff, deaths, you're not establishing a lack of peace whatsoever. Sorry, it's not working at all. And then they'll get discouraged and say, wow, why should we even bother then? You know, it'll deflate the whole thing that way. You're not bringing peace. You're just confirming and affirming that the effort to bring a lack of peace is futile. That's all. Okay, keep going on this. Tisha B'Av, Day of Doom. Where we're recognizing there is no doom. All right, maybe that's the next one. There is no doom. Okay, that's it.